3-part video on Valentine's Day dinner. Today is Valentine's Day 2016, and my husband and I, we bought some ribeye steaks from the meat market down the street, and they're good steaks. Nice and thick, really good, yummy steaks. I'm going to cook these up, and I'm going to make French fries, and I've made a video already on the French fries, so I'm not going to make another video, but the French fries, homemade, yummy French fries. I fried them up in my canola oil. This is the potato that I use. Thin skin potatoes is what I heard cooked up really good, less starch. So that's what I used, and that's what I bought this past time. So I'll be making those up as well. But this video, I want to show you asparagus. Let me get my stove going here, and I use Griswold pans. I love the Griswold pan. It's heavy. It's really heavy. Cooks really well. I used this last night, actually, to cook, and I'm going to use it tonight. But with the asparagus, I use a little bit of butter and salt and pepper in the asparagus, and that's it. I'm going to put in about 2 tablespoons right now.
What are you making?
A video.
Oh, shit.
2 tablespoons of butter. The guys are working out in the shop, and I thought I'd make a really quick video and get this going. And with asparagus, what you want to do is, when you buy it in the store, I already have a bunch that I've already snapped, but with asparagus, you want to make sure that you're careful in eating it. You don't want to eat the whole asparagus. I have been told that if you put water on the asparagus, or you cook it in a way, let me let the cat out. If you cook it in a way, it'll tender up. I don't, you have to soak it and whatever. I don't do that. With your asparagus, you need to snap it off. When you buy it in the store, it's good and it's fresh, but you want to snap off the end. Now listen, that was a hard snap. This here piece, I don't think is going to be good and tender, so I'm not going to feed that to my family. They're not going to like that. These guys are kind of picky about asparagus, and you know what? I don't like it either, but let's listen to this. That's kind of pushing it. I'm going to throw this piece in the trash, unfortunately, and this is the piece that we're going to eat. But when you look at your asparagus, there's a lot of asparagus that you're buying that you're not going to eat. Probably about this much you're not going to eat because it's tough. Like I said, there is a way to cook the asparagus, to soften it up, but I'm not sure how that works. And maybe someday I'll try it, because let me show you. This is what I got so far that I'm going to throw away, and it's unfortunate. It really is. Plus all of this, okay, and I haven't gone through this yet. So this is the asparagus that I'm going to cook up for my family. With asparagus, you really need to be careful. You need to make sure that it's not stringy. When it's stringy, nobody wants to eat it. And that's how I got my family to eat this. So I have butter melted in my pan. It's going to sizzle because I did just wash the asparagus. I cooked my asparagus for probably about 10 minutes, but it's crunchy. Yeah. I cooked this up so it's nice and crunchy, but it's hot, and with the butter that I have in there, it tastes really good. Make sure that you're careful with your asparagus. That sounded pretty good. So this here part I'm going to throw away, but this is the part I'll keep. And I start down kind of low at the end. That's kind of hard. And you can feel the hardness of it as well. That kind of sounded hard as well. I'll keep this, throw away that. Watch with your asparagus. Be careful of the stringy part. When you snap it, if it's a hard snap, it's not going to be good. You want to throw away the stem that you just snapped, and then you want to snap again, because this here part is going to be the tender. If your family doesn't like asparagus, it might be because it's just not tender enough, or if it's cooked too much or too little. One of the things I learned when I was a kid, my dad cooked broccoli. Hated broccoli. I hated broccoli. But he cooked it to mush. So I didn't eat it. I didn't like it. One day I was babysitting for a little boy and a little girl, and mom made their plates. And she said, okay, the kids have to eat what's on their plate. They can have more, of course, but they have to eat what's on their plate. Broccoli was on their plate, and they did not like it. But as the good babysitter, I said, you know what, guys, you got to eat it. But if you have to eat broccoli, I'm going to eat it too. And I did, and I liked it because it was crunchy. It wasn't soggy like my dad made it. I learned to love broccoli that's not cooked to mush. So cook your vegetables differently. If you mush your vegetables, if you cook them to death, try not cooking them that much. Try eating them raw. Some veggies are good raw. Carrots are great raw. Celery, broccoli, cauliflower, eat it raw. Try different things and see if your family will eat that. There's a lot of different ways to eat vegetables. This is just one way that we eat our asparagus. Actually, you know what? It's the only way we eat our asparagus. My husband wanted me to throw in some bacon in this. Right now, all my bacon's frozen, so I'm not going to pull it out, but I will do it probably tomorrow with the rest of this. Tonight, we're going to have homemade French fries. We're going to have asparagus and yummy, delicious steak. So, if you like the video, give me a thumbs up. If you have any questions, comment. Let me know how you cook your asparagus. Let me know different recipes. I love that. I'm always looking up on YouTube. If you have a YouTube channel, I'm probably watching you as how you cook up your asparagus, your steak, your potatoes, whatever. Give me a thumbs up. Thanks. Bye.